Today, ND filters for the Mavic 2 Pro. What they are, why you need them, and a comparison between the official DJI ones and the Freewheel ones which we found on Amazon. Coming right up. Felix here with Quadcopterguide, bringing you the best drone guides, reviews, and tips. On this channel, we do a lot of reviews like this one, so if you're new here, please subscribe. The first question, what are ND filters? Think of them as sunglasses for your drone, but not the ones like these, which have a gradient. Imagine if you had sunglasses where every single corner and every area of the sunglasses darken what you see exactly the same amount. That is what an ND filter is. They come in various strengths. It starts with ND2, which is just a very slight darkening, all the way up to ND2000. But the ones you're most likely going to need are ND8, ND16, and ND32. Now, why do you need ND filters? Usually with photography and videography, light is good, so why do we want to darken the image? ND filters give you more freedom on which shutter speed and aperture to use. You may think, hey, with the Mavic 2 Pro, we have physical aperture blades, we can just stop down the lens and then it'll allow us to use a slower shutter speed if we want. That is sort of true, but you also need to take into account that the camera is only its sharpest at a specific few f-stops or aperture settings. If you stop it down to f11, it starts to get less clear and sharp, so you want to try to avoid that. In a bit, I'll show you and give you the tools so you can test your own Mavic 2 Pro and see which f-stop is the sharpest on your drone. Now for videography, it's also important because there's this thing called the 180 degree shutter rule. 180 degree shutter rule, what's that? Essentially, your shutter speed for filming should be double of the frame rate you're shooting at.
Short quick history lesson, the 180 degrees out of the rule's name actually came from when we recorded on film using rotary shutters. This animated GIF from Wikipedia perfectly depicts that. So let's take a look. The shutter is rotating and it's blocking 180 degrees of a full circle. So each time the shutter passes the frame gets exposed to a specific amount of time. In today's standards, that would be double the frame rate. And if they wanted to use a different shutter speed, they would just swap out the shutter.
So for most of you that are shooting in NTSC mode, that would be North America and other countries where power runs at 60 hertz. If you're shooting at 30 frames a second, you want 1/60th of a shutter speed. Most Hollywood blockbusters are filmed using the 180 degree shutter rule. It gets you the most natural cinematic look. For the comparison, we have these official DJI Mavic 2 Pro ND filters linked in the description below. And we're gonna compare those to these Freewheel ND filters, which you can find on Amazon, also linked in the description below.
About a week after shooting that initial footage, Freewheel reached out to us and sent us this additional set. I'll explain why in a bit. And full disclosure, we purchased the DJI filters ourselves, and Freewheel sent us their filters to try out. Let's take a look at some of these sample images we took with the Mavic 2 Pro sporting some of these ND filters, and then we'll jump into the laboratory to take a look at the scientific test. This image is a JPEG straight out of the camera, and this is a H.264 video clip taken while using the DJI ND8 filter for the Mavic 2 Pro. And I'm really excited about this one. This is a bracket of 5 different exposures, so 5 photographs taken in RAW, and they're edited with 2 of my new favorite photography tools, which I will detail in coming up videos. So I had all these ND filters on hand for the Mavic 2 Pro, and I did manage to get the drone in the air with most of these filters attached for sample images and videos, but I also wanted to test them in a controlled environment. How would the filters compare to one another? Do they have different color shifts? Do they darken an image more than the other? Those questions I wanted answered. The testing setup. The Mavic 2 Pro is moved just a little bit more than the minimum focal distance away from the test image, and the lights are moved as close as possible to get as much light onto the charge as possible. And if you'd like to test your own Mavic 2 Pro to figure out what your sharpest f-stop is, or any other camera for that matter, you can download your own high resolution test chart here. So why look at some of these test images? Well, as you now know, ND filters do change the image, and ideally they darken all colors equally. Pretty much all manufacturers, this would include high-end filter manufacturers such as ones that make individual filters that cost multiple hundreds of dollars just for one filter, they all strive to produce a color shift-free filter. So for this ND filter test for the Mavic 2 Pro, I wanted to check if and which filters have any of these color shifts and or other artifacts. I'm sure you'll be surprised by the findings just like I was. I'm going to start with these images of this black and white test chart, and then we're going to jump into some actual photographs I took with the filters on the drone in the air. Here's the control image, taken with the normal UV filter which comes standard on the Mavic 2 Pro. As you can see, it's a little bit bright, and it was actually metering at plus 2 EV. I happen to be located in Germany, so my goal is to shoot videos at 1/50th of a second shutter speed. Now, these are photographs we're looking at, but you will notice color shifts earlier in photographs. I'll show you the video equivalents in a sec. Here, the ND4 from DJI looks just fine. Ah, interesting. Here with the ND8 filter from DJI, I'm starting to see a very slight color shift at the sides where the studio lights are the brightest. Here, another look at the same filter. This time in aperture priority mode, it shows its own shutter speed to get a zero exposure value. Interestingly, in video mode, the color shift is less noticeable. Here, the ND16 for the Mavic 2 Pro, showing a more pronounced color shift where the lights are reflecting. The same filter at zero exposure value, and the ND16 in video mode. Here, the DJI ND32 filter, and the red shift is more pronounced where the lights are reflecting. Also note I had to bump up the ISO to 200 because it was just getting too dark. The same ND32 at zero exposure value, and the ND32 in video mode, also ISO 200. And now the Freewell ND filters for the Mavic 2 Pro. This is the limited edition filter 6-pack, part of their 4K series. These filters also include a polarizer, but I've got it set to no polarization for these tests. Interestingly, there's a 0.6 EV difference in exposure between the Freewell and the DJI ND4 filters. Here, the ND8 polarizer from Freewell, you can start to see a hint of that red color where the lights are reflecting. And here the comparison. The same filter at 0 EV, and here the matching video. Here it starts to get pretty interesting with the ND16 polarizer from Freewell. If we compare that to the DJI, take a look at the color difference. For the ND16 polarizer, 0 EV. And for that filter, the video. And the last filter we can compare to the DJI ones because the DJI ones only go up to ND32. Also note the jump up to ISO 200 once again. Here, the ND32 polarizer from Freewell compared to the DJI ND32 filter. Here, the Freewell ND32 polarizer at 0 EV. And here, the filter in video mode. And quickly, the ND64 polarizer up at ISO 400. The filter at EV0. And the corresponding video. And if there's ever the need, perhaps you want to shoot a welding scene or something and you want to see the sparks clearly, the ND1000 here at 0 EV at ISO 3200. Now let's compare some sample images I took with the Mavic 2 Pro in the air. On the left, the ND4 filter from DJI, and on the right, the ND4 from Freewell. Now a similar comparison, but using the ND8 filters from both. Now here's the best video comparison I could find in the video files I shot. All the other ones, the clouds had moved or the sun was behind the clouds and made it really difficult to compare. So basically just judge the colors on this and not the exposure because the exposure is slightly different. Okay, now we're back to comparing photos. Here left, DJI ND16, and on the right, the Freewell ND16. You can see that filters from both brands produce sharp images. It's just that DJI has more of a warm hue or tone to them, and the Freewell filters produce more of a cooler, bluish hue, both of which you can, of course, edit in post-production. Okay, I think that's enough looking at test charts, test images, and test videos. So which ND filter set should you purchase for your Mavic 2 Pro? That is the question, isn't it? Well, there's a couple of different things you should consider. I'll sum them up in three categories. One, the fit and finish of the filters. Two, the image quality. Of course, also very important. Number three, the price of the filter set. Let's jump into fit and finish. First, you may notice on these official DJI filters, there's these metal plate inlays in the opposite sides of the filter. It turns out these are important to have the filter fit correctly on the drone. Notice that these inlays are also on the Freewell filter on the right, and that they were not in the middle. Interestingly, it turns out that there's actually two variants of the filter slots floating around out there on production Mavic 2 Pros. Long story short, according to Freewell, all filters currently available feature these metal inlays, so you don't have to worry. Another important thing to consider is filter coating. We could not confirm if the DJI ones are multi-coated. DJI support could not answer that for me. I've got a request into the technical department to clarify. On the website, it doesn't say it, so I can't say for sure, but the Freewell ones are multi-coated. They claim to have 16 layers of coating on their filters. Multi-coating helps reduce lens flare. so it's always good to have. Be sure to check the first comment below. I will update it with the information I receive back from DJI. On to the next category, image quality. We saw that the DJI filters had that color shift, or maybe better said, the artifacting earlier than the FreeWheel ones. But if we compare the images taken outside, here the best example once again, the ND4 comparison, as the sun was shining the most similar in brightness, you can see that the main difference is just the slight hue. The DJI filters being a little bit warmer, and the FreeWheel filters being a little bit cooler. And the last category, price. The original DJI ND filter set consists of these four filters, and the limited edition pack from FreeWheel is made up of six filters. Additionally, you might be interested in a smaller set of filters from FreeWheel. They also sell sets of four or individual filters, so be sure to check those out.
Hey, thank you for watching. Everything we reviewed today is available in the YouTube description below.
And for you, the hardcore that watched this till the end, listen to these cowbells in the background.
And the free resources are available on our blog, quadcopterguide.com, also linked below. Till next time.
If any of that information was helpful to you, I would really appreciate it if you hit that like button. It does help out a lot. Thanks.